Welcome back to Pastry Maestra. I'm Teresa and today I'm making Ischler cookies. Ischler cookies are considered to be one of the finest examples of the Austro-Hungarian monarchy's pastry tradition, originated in Bad Ischl, a famous spa town in Upper Austria, where the Emperor Franz Joseph I enjoyed his summers. In 1832, Johann Zauner, a well-known winemaker and merchant from Vienna, decided to expand his business to Bad Ischl, so he founded the pastry shop Zauner, and that is where these delicate cookies were born. Austrian Emperor himself gladly visited Zauner's pastry shop to treat himself to Ischler cookies. Although there is a rumor that he just claimed he went to the pastry shop while he was actually visiting his mistress who lived nearby. Naughty Emperor. Anyway, fun and impressive fact. With or without the Emperor and his mistress, Zauner is still up and running even today, almost 200 years later. Wow! There are so many different recipes for this royal treat. Ischler cookies are essentially cookie sandwiches. Take two cookies enriched with walnuts, almonds or hazelnuts. Put some filling like chocolate buttercream, apricot or raspberry jam in between and cover with chocolate glaze. Voila! By the way, if you want to learn how to make buttercream, check my post. The link is down below. Anyway, every household in Croatia has its own recipe, and each one of them is, of course, the best and the only true recipe. Yeah, right. So, which one is the original? According to the books, the original recipe consists of nut cookies filled with chocolate buttercream and glazed with chocolate. Allegedly, in Zauner pastry shop, there was another Ischler recipe where the cookies were sandwiched with sour jam and glazed with coffee glaze. But I couldn't find a solid confirmation or denial of this claim. Anyway, since I think that there is never too much chocolate in one's life, on this occasion I will show you how to make chocolate-filled and chocolate-glazed Ischler cookies. So, let's go! As usual, the recipe is on my site, the link is down below. To make the cookie dough, the first thing I'm gonna do is cream my room temperature butter and powdered sugar into a bowl of a stand mixer fitted with pedal attachment. I'm gonna add the egg and continue mixing until incorporated. My mixture is nice and smooth, and now I'm gonna fold in sifted flour and toasted ground hazelnuts. I'm gonna wrap the dough in plastic film, flatten it, and chill in the fridge for at least an hour. My dough is chilled. I'm gonna roll it on a floured surface to 5 mm, which is about 1/4 inch thickness. Now I'm gonna cut out circles 5 cm, which is 2 inches in diameter, and place them on paper-lined baking tray. I'm gonna bake my cookies at 180 degrees centigrade, which is 350 degrees Fahrenheit, for about 10 to 15 minutes until golden on the edges. To make French buttercream, the first thing I'm gonna do is make pâte à bombe, which is a mixture of whipped egg yolks and cooked sugar syrup. I'm gonna place egg yolks into a bowl of a stand mixer fitted with whisk attachment and start mixing on medium speed. I'll put sugar and water enough to cover the sugar into a saucepan and put the lid on. Once my syrup boils, the steam will wash down sugar crystals from the sides of the pan and I'm gonna remove the lid. I'm gonna insert the probe of my digital candy thermometer into the syrup and continue cooking until it reaches 118 degrees centigrade, which is 244 degrees Fahrenheit. At that point, I'm gonna pour it carefully without turning off my mixer into whipped egg yolks. It is important to pour the syrup between the whisk and the side of the mixing bowl. Be very careful. If you pour the syrup directly on the whisk while it's working, that could splatter your hands or face with hot sugar syrup and you could get serious burns. Once all the syrup is in, I'm gonna continue whisking pâte à bombe until it cools down. My pâte à bombe is cooled and now I'm gonna start adding softened butter gradually until everything is incorporated. Now I'm gonna mix in chocolate that I've melted in the microwave. Be careful that chocolate isn't too hot because it might melt the butter in buttercream. At the end, I'm gonna mix in the rum. My cookies are cooled. I've filled my piping bag fitted with 1 cm, which is 3/8 of an inch tip, with chocolate buttercream. And now I'm gonna pipe a blob of cream on one cookie and then I'm gonna sandwich it with another cookie. I'll put my Ischler cookies in the fridge for a couple of minutes and then smooth the sides with my silicone spatula. Once smooth, I'll return them in the fridge to set completely. While my cookies are chilling, I'm gonna prepare the glaze. To do that, I've melted my chocolate in the microwave and now I'm gonna add neutral tasting coconut oil and mix it in. I've placed my cookies onto a rack and now I'm gonna glaze them with my chocolate glaze. Finally, I'm gonna decorate my cookies with some melted white chocolate. There, my Ischler cookies are done and now I have to put them in the fridge and wait for about 15 minutes until the glaze becomes firm. This is the hard part, but I don't mind waiting because I know that my patience will be rewarded. I recommend you do the same. Enjoy!
Oh baby, you are so sweet. So delicious and yummy, so good to eat. I wanna lick you, feel your sweetness on my lips. Forever and ever, you'll stay on my hips.
I'm Teresa. Thanks for watching my video. I hope you liked it. If you wanna stay in touch, follow me on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram, and of course, visit my site, where you can find elaborate posts with lots of pictures, additional information and recipes that follow my every video. Also, on my site you can download my free 365 pages ebook The Pastry Chef and maybe buy me a macaron, if you think that I've earned it. Now, before you go, please hit the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. That really helps a lot. Finally, and this is the most important thing, don't forget to create sweetness every day, because sweetness is happiness. See you in my next video. Bye!